Well, it's my beautiful little scenic getaway. I like to come here and hide out. So, the test on the microphone worked pretty good. It's not even a... not even really a microphone. Well, I guess it is. It's a piece to a cell phone. But I cut the earbuds off and it works pretty good. Got it tucked up in my chin padding. Of course, it wants to rip my eye off every time I take my helmet off, but it's cool. So, what I will be discussing today, so I'm still kind of new, bike rider. I rode dirt bikes for a long time as a kid, and always said that, you know, I wanted to get my, my license, but never did. Never the right time. And finally I said, forget it, I'm gonna do it. So, me and my wife went through the MSF course. And it was fun. I mean, I knew how to ride, so I was already riding. But, anyway, moral of the story. I never really got to ride with anybody. I was always just, you know, by myself. And finally got the opportunity to do it. And a couple buddies of mine from work, it was been like 10 of us, he said, oh, we're going to go take a run to Philly. Come along. So I didn't want to seem like a coward. And I said, of course. I have never been on the parkway. I've never been on, like, long runs, you know? So I was a little scared. And that guy's got a lot of baggage. But, like I said, I did. So, he says, they're from, I don't know if anybody's familiar with Jersey, but they're from Newark and, Bergen. It's up North Jersey. Like, I guess exit would be like, 140-something. Be a little more on the parkway. Exit 117. So, he says, well, just get on Parkway South and pull over and we'll meet ya. Okay. So I did, and I'm sitting there, and I'm like, man, this is gonna be crazy. My heart's beating. I don't know. I'm not a very, like, I'm not a super skilled rider yet, and that seems like one hell of a ride. But I didn't want to seem like a wuss, so I did it, and I'm waiting there, and then I hear the rumble, and so it just seemed like a whole bunch of bikes pulling up, and, you know, like their hand signals, you know, pull over, and they all did it, like, they all pulled over in such a fashion, like, serious, you know, they're just uniform. These guys were on point, and, I got the big Kool-Aid grin, you know, hard, just cheesing, because first time riding with a group of guys, and it was cool. So we start riding, and they took like the scenic route to Philadelphia. I had no idea you could even do that, but it was an awesome ride, real scenic and everything. you know, like, we rode in formation the whole way, you know, and, like, we were, you go to a stop sign, there's, like, in Philly, there's, like, tons of these one-way streets, right? And we were going to, like, these, you know, touristy cheesesteak places. Like, the first guy would go and kind of block traffic so everybody else could just, you know, it was cool. It was an experience. And I had a freaking blast. So, you know, if there's, like, something in the road, you see, like, a little pothole or, you know, some crap, debris in the road, they're, like, oy, you know, mark it off, point to it, you know what I mean? They were on it. So, nice, shorts on a bike. So it was cool. And coming from, you know, I've never ridden with anyone. I'm always by myself just putting around. It was really awesome. I had such a good time. So, I mean, if you got the opportunity to ride with a group of people, man, there's absolutely nothing like it. Just, you know, like a whole bunch of bikes, you know, and they all got cool bikes, and my bike is completely awesome. So, just seeing all this, you know, loud rumbling bikes coming by, and, you know, kids liked it. Everybody looked at us, you know, we pull into the gas station, and it was cool. It was really cool. So, I highly suggest doing that. And, yeah, it's great. I would like to do some runs. Like bike runs. I know that people go on these long, you know, like a couple hundred bikes driving down the damn road. That seems awesome. Like, I would totally enjoy that. Couple of my buddies got bikes, and I've been dying to get like a nice little ride together with them, but it's not easy, you know, especially people got crap to do, whatever. But I'm always down to ride. I know I've watched a lot of vloggers, and there's a couple Jersey cats. I think it was a NJ Bike Life or something like that. I think he's in, like, Howell, Tom's River area or something, and which isn't far from me. It's a little bit nice little ride, but that would be cool. Kappa something. You know, I'm sorry if I don't get your name right, but it's like Kappa Meduta Medoro. Anyway, another Jersey guy. I see him, like, I see the videos. See him, I think he's going through, like, Rumson, it looked like, in Seabright, which is not that far from me. It is actually right behind me, by the beach. Right by the beach, man. I'd love to reach out to those guys, get together, do some riding, little double vlog. I don't know if we passed it. If anybody's familiar with the movie Clerks. The old, what is it, Stop and Go, Stop and Shop, I think it's Stop and Go, is it down one of these streets, you know, Kevin Smith, is a Leonardo guy. He grew up around here, Highlands, whatever. And no, not that one. I think it's behind me. But it was pretty cool, you know, watching the movie and being like, oh snap, I know right where that's at. And it's funny because you go in there and it was like an Indian dude. And who was not amused with just constant people going in there being like, yeah, let me get a pack of smokes. You know, movie quotes. I'm not even supposed to be here today. But I think that video store is there though. I think that was like made up. And was it Jersey Girl or something? Some ridiculously garbage movie with Ben frickin' Affleck. That was like, I guess, based in Highlands, which again is behind me. I don't know how much they did in the Highlands, but it was pretty cool. There's been a couple movies, you know, Jersey, and I think like Coyote Ugly. She was supposed to be from South Amboy, which is this tiny butt crack town. I'm not gonna say butt crack town because I grew up right by South Amboy, and but it's just never been swing bada 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 bada. It's never been it ain't much over there, but I think it's like 1 square mile, and I know it got into the Guinness Book. Don't quote me on this, but I believe it got into the Guinness Book for most bars in, you know, such a small area. Because there was, growing up, there was literally, closed. There was literally a bar on every corner, and it was just a bunch of drunks. But yep, the joys of Jersey. Now, when I was coming down here, it was a little poor raccoon that got hit and started a little commotion. See if anything happened. I think it was down this road. As the lady was, she was about to call the cops or animal control or something. But he got hit, man. I felt so bad. He just kind of like limped across the street, plopped down in the grass, but his face was all, like, he was bleeding from his mouth. And then there was the guy on the bicycle, like, dude, he's got rabies. Look at my shadow. Look how tough that is. My God. So sexy. So, grew up in, like I said, right by South Amboy there, a little place of Sayreville. Home of John Bon Jovi, that guy. And we just bought our first house, yay for us, here in the Burg, Keensburg, and I'm still trying to find my way through here, but I keep finding all these little, I found this street, and I find it, it's not like a mystery, apparently everybody does it, but you see this, it's like these little picnic-y beach areas that you could just go to. How awesome. I'm not really a beach person. I like the beach, but I think I might have to start going to said beaches. I don't swim. I sink, so, and I'm afraid of what's in the water. But I like to dip my toes in. Get a little salty air. Ah, boats. Some boats. Boats and racks. Fishing boats. Shrimping boats. Stripper boats. Guys. Fishing? Crabbing? Crabbing? Crabbing off the dock? Oh, look at the water. There was animal control. That's the little raccoon. Oh, poor feller. I think that was the lady. This bike is ridiculous. I love this bike, but it's got the Conquest Customs. I know you can see that exhaust. And literally, my leg melts. I have, like, I wear Dickies. I'm a Dickies guy, okay? Yeah, I like my Dickies. I have to wear them for work. I don't have to, I choose to, but they're work pants, right? And back in my teenage years, I found a fascination of the, I guess, West Coast life, and I embraced that cholo style. So I've just always worn Dickies, okay? Dickies are not good with heat, extreme heat, like a damn muffler. Sitting against them, and I burned a hole in like two of my pair of pants, and my leg, it like set on fire. It was ridiculously hot, and it hurt. And now I try to wear jeans when I ride, and it, you could see the burn mark on my jeans. I burn everything. These pipes, they stick out. The stock pipes are down more and kind of hidden. It's all good. These suckers, holy moly. I'm like, melt my huevos every time. Come on, buddy. So, the test is complete, I guess, with the microphone. This little bike right here. It's so cool looking. It's a Harley Davidson. It's not that I have anything against Harleys. I like them. If I had to ride a Harley, I would, but it would be like something classic, something cool. But these victories, man, damn the Ness family, you are good. They killed it. They really did. They do such a great job. Get my bike back in. It's cool.